Good evening and welcome to the Farmingdale High School PlayCrafters production of Pippin. Please take a moment and silence your cell phones as they are disturbing to the actors and interfere with our sound system. There will be a 15-minute intermission where refreshments will be sold. Food and drink are not permitted inside the auditorium. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy Pippin.
Oh, loss, murder, and holy war, and a climax. Ladies and gentlemen, a climax you will remember for the rest of your lives. Not now, later. Our tale today concerns the firstborn son of Charlemagne and is entitled... Pippin is Life and Times. But before we begin, there have been many misconceptions about Pippin. One, that he was
a hunchback.
That he was
enormously tall.
That he was
extremely short.
That he was
completely bald at the age of 14.
But I beg you, cast all previous misconceptions aside. Our story begins as Pippin's childhood ends.
His last day at the University of Padua, where his father had sent him.
So that he might embark upon his life with a maximum of choices.
And possibilities.
Pippin so distinguished himself at the university that the faculty bestowed upon him the special title of
Scholar of the House!
And Pippin responded in his own deeply moving words. He may be a little nervous. This is his first time playing the role.
Could I have some more light, please?
Well, he's not that nervous.
Thank you. Gentle tutors, respected members of the faculty, I am so grateful for the knowledge that you've given me. But I'm afraid that what I'm looking for can't be found in books.
And Pippin made a promise.
I promise not to waste my life on commonplace, ordinary pursuits. I'm going to live a life that's extraordinary. I know there's something, I just can't find the word for it.
Fulfilling? Something completely fulfilling.
Yeah, that's it. Something completely fulfilling. And I'm gonna find it. I don't know where I wanna go or what I wanna do. Everything has its season, everything has its time. Show me a reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. So why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Every man has his daydreams, every man has his goal. People like the way dreams have of sticking. Nightingales have their song. Don't you see I want my life to be something more than long? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Till I know I have it all. So don't ask where I'm going, just listen when I'm gone. And far away you'll hear me singing softly to the dawn. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly.
trained by an actor of enormous power!
Power! Power! Power! We joined Charlemagne in the midst of his royal council. It's been a long day.
And that is why, sire, I humbly beseech you to reduce my levy of foot soldiers and cattle.
And next!
Oh, great leader! Blessed by God! Sent to us from heaven to protect us from the infidel!
No! Not all that rubbish again. What is it?
Sire, due to a famine, my fields are barren. I ask you to—
Denied! Next!
Sire.
Denied!
But sire, I protest that is unjust and tyrannical.
Take that man away and hang him!
No. Please!
Help! Everybody out!
No!
But wait, sire.
I said everybody out!
But father, it's me, Pippin.
Pippin? Oh, Pippin!
Wait, what are you doing here?
I'm home, father. I finished school.
Already? Well then,
how did it go? Oh, very well, father.
Good.
You know I'm a great believer in education.
And yet you become the most powerful man in the world without it.
The most powerful man in the world? What about the Pope?
I rank you above the Pope, sir.
And I happen to agree with you. Well, Pippin, it was good to see you.
But wait, father.
You know we have ourselves a library now. Maybe you could find a book.
Well, thank you.
After all, tomorrow is for you.
But it's still today.
Yes, but for how long? You'll see, Pippin. Sunrise and sunset are similar, but they are not identical.
Father, what does that even mean?
Enter, Louis. Pippin's half-brother, and, after Pippin, heir to the throne, addicted to the physical. Louis loves weightlifting. Louis loves wrestling. But most of all, Louis loves Louis.
Ha! Visigoths! Well done, brother. Of course it was. Did you know this arm slew 20 Frisians last year? And it's gonna slay more Visigoths.
You're going to war against the Visigoths?
Uh-huh. That's the next one. It's gonna be a glorious campaign and... Oh, those Visigoth women. I don't mean to shock your bookish sensibilities.
I'm only shocked you're interested in women now.
Enter Fostrada. Pippin's stepmother. Crafty. Cunning. Calculating.
But a warm and wonderful mother.
Dedicated to gaining the throne for her darling son, Louis.
Louis! Guess what mommy made for you? Surprise!
Thank you, mother. Think I'll shine. Look at this, isn't it a beauty?
It really is beautiful.
Of course it's beautiful. Louis is a great warrior.
Ha! Visigoths!
What? Me? Oh. We're so proud of Louis, aren't we, dear? Oh, my darling. darling, before I forget, the royal treasurer informs me I've somehow overdrawn my allowance account.
You're overdrawn again?
Now, now, my lord. You know how confused I get about money. After all, I'm just an ordinary housewife and mother. Just like all you housewives and mothers out there!
You know, sometimes I wonder if the fornicating I'm getting is a... It's worse the fornicating I'm getting.
Father, I know what I want to do now.
Oh, good, good.
What is it?
I want to be a soldier.
A waggle.
Denied!
But Father, I'm your oldest son. That means that one day I'm going to be king. And isn't fighting wars an important part of being king?
Fighting wars is the most important part of being king. After all, the Pope and I have dedicated ourselves to spreading Christianity across the entire world. Even if we have to kill every non-Christian to do it.
Exactly. So that's why I want to join you in your campaign against the Visigoths.
Denied!
But Father, that's not fair. You're taking Louis.
Yes, but your brother Louis is an ideal warrior. He's strong and stupid. You, on the other hand, are educated.
And for what? Father, you're dedicated to something. I want to be dedicated to something too, with all my heart and soul, something important and meaningful.
Aww. You want your life to have meaning?
Yes, I do.
Well, that is very ambitious of you, Pippin! Denied!
But Father...
Denied!
Father, you created an entire empire out of nothing. And now I want my chance. My chance to fight for my country, for my family, for my king.
All right, go grab yourself a decent helmet and come along. I'm a soldier.
Yes, you are.
Me, a warrior. Finally, a chance to do something important. To use my sword, my arm, and maybe even my blood.
Tomorrow's skirmish! tell me of the enemy, a station on the hill. Shall we dust to throw them down here where they're easy to kill? So you in the ravine, that's this area green. When we walk across the plain, where you fill in it can be seen. Mine and the enemy in blue will undoubtedly pursue. And we'll have to keep your losses to comparatively few. Kill the blues, kill the blues, kill the blues, and victory! And then... And then the men go marching out to the fray, conquering the enemy, carrying the day. Hark, the blood is pounding in our ears. Jubilation, we can hear a grateful nation's cheers. Sit down immediately. I'm sorry. Now, where was I? Yes! A general except the walls, and even worse, you must never be too cautious to all kinds of the adverse. I've got in the majority of blood that you will spatter, will be there for just a minimum of damage, just collateral. But we know for success, you must also pay the price. That's why for my success, you must sacrifice. Ha! Oh, me and Ben!
And
gentlemen, Kevin! And then the men go marching out into the fray.
I'm sorry, Father.
Well, now time's running short. I'll have to speed the whole damn thing up! A one, a two, a one, two, three, four! Now, three men is dying never to explain what separates a charlatan from a charlemagne. A room on a general, the last rings and various, the palms and the poly of Eric and the Darius. A little woman every leader knows by heart. It's more to be lucky that it's not enemy small. Now and then.
Glory! did very well.
Well, now we suck. And yes, it's required. And singing is essential in a day.
And then the men heard the notes go up to the fans.
And then you're not joining in. 4, 2, 3.
Give thanks to God for granting us the story and business.
Wonder who this man was.
It is a little late, but as long as you're interested. I'm just a common man, a Visigoth, but a good man, a very good man.
You're also a very lucky man. You've had the privilege of dying for your king.
Words fail me.
You know, of course, dying in battle like this, you'll be sent straight to Valhalla or wherever your infidels go.
Oh, absolutely. Our king has assured us personally. But this waiting around's got me a bit edgy.
This wasn't your first battle, was it?
No, my third.
So then maybe you can help me. Do you mind telling me, how does this battle compare to your other two?
Well, unless you get killed, one battle's pretty much like another.
I was afraid you'd say that.
Whoa, 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 whoa!
Alright, well, I hope you get to Valhalla.
Hope you get to heaven!
Oh, I will.
And Pippin, this is embarrassing! A victory celebration? But my own son not joining in.
I'm sorry, Father. You're going to have to get used to victory celebrations without me. I thought there'd be more plumes.
Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run.
Well, I'll sing you the story of a sorrowful lad. He had everything he wanted and then want what he had. He had wealth and help and name and fame and all that noise, but didn't have none of those simple joys. His life seemed purposeless and flat. Aren't you glad you don't feel like that?
So he ran from all the needy dummy, ran from things he just begun, he ran from himself.
Out in the country where he played as a boy, he had to find some simple joy. He wanted some place warm and green. We all could use a change of scene. Sweet summer evenings, hot wine and bread, sharing your supper.
Joys have a simple voice that says, why not go ahead?
And would you rather be a left-handed sleeve, a crab on a slab at the bottom of the sea, than a man who never learns how to be free? Not till he's cold and dead.
Dumb every dollar.
by myself.
Warm.
Strong.
So attractive.
Very attractive.
Charlemagne's mother, exiled from court
due to a personality conflict with her daughter-in-law, Fastrada.
Grandma!
I hate needlepoint.
Ah, but you're so good at it.
Pippin? Oh, Pippin! Pippin, I can't believe it. Oh, how good it is to see you, to hold you the way I used to.
Grandma, you look great.
No, I don't. I look terrible.
No, you look great.
No, I don't. I look terrible.
All right, fine. You look terrible.
Is that any way to talk to your grandmother?
But actually, Pippin, you look terrible. You need some fresh air, some good food, some hanky-panky.
I don't know what I need.
Oh, I know what I need. Some good, juicy gossip. You have to tell me what's going on in court. Is that good-looking priest still leading confession?
Grandma, you haven't changed a bit.
Oh, but you have, Pippin. Tell me, what have you been doing with yourself?
Well, I went to war.
That explains it.
I tried to own my own manhood, you know? Give my blood back. But that didn't work, and it just left me feeling empty and vacant. So what I think I need is a plan. Yeah, that's it. A goal and a plan. Well, I have a goal. I want to be fulfilled. But for a good plan. You see, that's what I've been thinking about. Because, I mean, you can't just go rushing into whatever comes along and hope for the best. But, I mean, on the other hand, you can't just sit around waiting for expecting someone to just fall into your lap, so, you know.
You lost me in the middle there, Pippin. Come here. You think too much. That's your problem. You have to learn to live in the moment. Look at this day. Look at it. The sun is shining, the air is warm, and maybe later tonight, down at the tavern, there's that lovely young girl you could hook up with and do all those things you kids do, and then come back and tell me everything in graphic detail.
Grandma, I don't have time for that.
Time? Now, Pippin, you listen to me. I'm an expert on time. When you are as old as I, my dear, and I hope that you never are, you will woefully wonder why, my dear, through your cataracts and catarrh, you can squander away or sequester a drop of a precious year. For when your best days are yester, the rest are twice as dear. What good is a field on a fine summer night if you sit all alone with the weeds? Or a succulent pear, and with each juicy bite, you spit out your teeth with the seeds. Before it's too late, stop trying to wait for fortune and fate you're secure of. For there's one thing to be sure of, mate. There's nothing to be sure of. Oh, it's time to start living. Time to take a little from this world you're given. Time to take time, for spring will turn to fall. In just no time at all.
But Grandma, it's time that I'm worried about.
Now you sit down, and you don't say anything until I'm finished. I've got 3 more choruses to do. You can join in with me if you wish. And that goes for all of you out there too. All of you just staring at me, looking dumbfounded. But just the choruses, the verses are all mine. I never wondered if I was afraid when there was a challenge to take. And I never thought about how much I weighed when there was still one piece of cake. Maybe it's been bent, feeling broken, bent and unwell. But there's still no cure, so Evan sent as the chance to raise some hell. Everybody go. One, two, three, four.
Maybe that's the secret to life. Just live in the moment.
Enjoy the simple things. The fresh air. The cool, clean water. The fresh fruit off the... Oh yes. And women.
Last presented pastorally.
My days are brighter than morning air, evergreen pine and autumn blue. But all my days were twice as fair if I could share my days with you. Warmer than fire coals, incense and stars and smoked bamboo. But nights were warm beyond compare if I could share my nights with you. To dance in my dreams, shine when I need the sun, with you to hold me when dreams are done. And oh my dearest love, if you ribbons of memories, too sweet in life when youth is through. But I would need no memories then if I could share my life with you.
Thank you.
please.
Boy, when you frolic, you really frolic, don't you? Well, how do you feel now?
Empty and vacant.
Oh, I don't know. What you were doing back there seemed like pretty fun to me.
But it wasn't fulfilling. Why can't I find something completely fulfilling?
Look, you just got started. There are still so many things you could try.
Like what?
Like taking a look at this.
Peasants revolt. King slays thousands? Peasants protesting rise in taxes slaughtered yesterday by Charlemagne soldiers? What? This can't be true.
Now, would a newspaper print anything that wasn't true?
My father would never slaughter people just for protesting.
Why not? He's the king. Charlemagne today has given orders that any non-believers be given the choice between baptism and beheading.
Wait. Forcing people to believe? Telling them what to think? Something has got to be done about this.
You're absolutely right.
I'm finally beginning to see who my father really is. He forces people to fight and die over land that's not even theirs.
He does!
Well, this has got to stop.
It has got to stop!
It's time for a change!
Damn it, it's time for a change!
You know, it doesn't even matter that he's my father. We can't just sit around and expect for someone else to do something. Otherwise, one day, we'll all just look around and ask ourselves, what happened? What happened is we failed to act.
Down with Charles! 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 Down with Charles!
Testing?
Testing.
It's time to make a better world for all people, not just the rich and powerful. This tyrant must be overthrown! Yeah. Terror and bloodshed must be ended!
Yeah.
We need a leader with the youth and courage to sweep out the old order.
Yeah.
Down with Charles! Up with me?
Pippin is disloyal to you, my lord.
Every son is disloyal to his father at one time or another, my lady.
But Louis loves you, my lord.
Louis is an ass. My love.
Despite this rejection, I took upon my tiny shoulders the task of effecting a rapprochement between two men for whom I felt deeply. Back in my younger days, if things were going wrong, I might sulk, I might pout. Now I've learned if I just pitch in and do what's right, things will always work out. And if we all could spread a little sunshine, all could light a little fire, we all would be a little closer to our heart's desire. My lord?
Yes, my lady?
Will you be praying at Arles next month?
No. I don't think so, my lady.
Oh, but my lord, you always feel so much better after your yearly prayer.
I do?
Yes, you do. I sought out Pippin. Your father loves you.
Freedom and dignity for all men is more important than the love between one father and one son.
Still, Your name will be on his lips when he prays. At Arles. Next month. Alone.
Alone?
And unguarded.
What date?
The 15th. Pip and I beg you to bring this estrangement to an end.
I intend to.
May I tell your father this resolve?
No. Let it be a surprise.
A surprise? I love surprises!
Mama, if Pippin kills father...
You'll be next in line for the throne, darling!
But if father discovers Pippin's plot and executes
him... You'll be next in line for the throne, darling!
Mama, no matter what, I'll move up.
Yes, darling. I know the parables told in the holy book. I keep close on my shelf. God's wisdom teaches me when I help others, I'm really helping myself. And if we
disaster. The Royal Chapel at Arles.
It's all right, Father. You may come in.
I am sorry to disturb you, my son.
You know who I am, Father?
Of course, my son.
Well, you want something from me, perhaps? A favor? Advancement?
I'm here to be with you for one moment, to look into your eyes.
And what do you see?
I see two eyes, a little cloudy with age. Sunset.
And what else?
The death of thousands, the slavery of more, terror and bloodshed.
You see all that in my eyes?
Do you deny it?
Deny it? I'm proud of it! I brought order out of chaos! If terror and bloodshed was necessary to achieve that order, well then so be it.
Those are words from the past. Time has passed you by! My son.
And your time has come? My son?
Yes, Father.
It's so easy, from where you stand, to judge the things that I've done. Eagles, ospreys, even vultures had a better view. From the heights, all things were very clear. But when I watched, dust of the road was in my mouth. And when I thought, the blood of the enemy was in my eye. But by God, I blew my breath across an entire continent and shaped an empire with it.
Father, maybe you did the best you could, but things have to change.
And you're the one to change them?
Yes, I am.
Well then, if you truly think that, then there is only one thing that you must do.
Thank you. I brought my own.
Then use it! Or go, and leave me to my prayers.
What do you pray for, Father?
Strength. And may God grant you the same... Oh!
I want my hands to stop shaking when all the earth is still, when ancient ghosts are waking, so many steps need taking, so many plans need making, I think I will. I think I will.
Your Majesty, King Pippin.
Your Majesty.
Your Highness, King Pippin.
Morning glow, morning glow. Starts to glimmer when you know. Winds of change are set to blow and sweep this whole land through. Morning glow is long past due.
hear petitions.
Come forward. You will all be dealt with fairly. My invitation extends to high and low alike.
Sire, I am a poor man.
You may stand. You may all stand.
Thank you. Sire, I am a poor man, a peasant. I own not one millimeter of land, in which I've worked so hard for all of my life. Is that fair?
No, that is completely unfair. But I will do something about it. I hereby decree that from now on, all peasants shall own the land they cultivate.
What? King Pippin, the Just.
Sire, now that you've given our land to the peasants, we loyal nobles have no source of income. Therefore, we cannot pay our taxes.
Well, then I abolish taxes.
King Pippin, the generous.
You realize, sire, without taxes, you'll have no money to support an army.
That's all right. I don't need an army. That's it. No more taxes, no more army.
King Pippin, the peaceful.
Hey, Pippin. Sire, it is my duty to inform you that the infidel Hun have attacked in the east. They have destroyed 3 villages and murdered thousands of royal subjects. But he will withdraw under one condition.
Well, that's
very reasonable. What's the condition?
He wants your reproductive organs on a pike staff.
Well.
In that case, I guess you're just gonna have to go out there and destroy the infidel.
But, sire, we have no army.
Good point. Noble?
Yes, sire?
Do you remember that decree I made a little while ago about land and taxes? Yeah, that's off.
What? But, sire, without land, we have neither money nor power over the peasants.
Peasant?
Yes, sire.
I hereby suspend land reform.
Suspend land reform?
Can we give it back? That's right, give it back.
Up thine, sire!
Take that man away and hang him.
No! Please don't take me away, not again! No, please!
No, no, stop, wait, just, please, let me just think of it, please.
Darling, you're a born ruler. You're doing a wonderful job. Nothing has changed since your father died. Now about my royal allowance.
Deny! King Pippin, the unpopular.
I need to pray.
Pray? You're the king! What in the world would you have to pray for?
Strength.
Is there anything else you'd like?
Yeah, I'd like my knife back.
You want it? You got it. Illusion, fantasies to study.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, Father.
Well, that's all right, son! Just don't let it happen again.
Oh! Every child in there
I was determined to somehow pierce that dedicated apathy. Now, I've found that no man, no matter what his condition, can resist the charm of a growing boy. So I sent my son Theo to him.
Enter, Theo.
A lovable boy and his lovable duck.
Pippin, say hello to my duck.
Oh, how do you do?
Guess his name.
I don't know, Augustus.
Wrong. His name's Otto. You're not very smart.
I'm smart enough to know that a duck belongs in a pond and not in my bed.
Bite me.
Pippin, you've been lying in bed for 7 days now. What is the matter with you?
It's nothing you can possibly understand.
Well, try me. Give me a chance. Yeah!
Alright. I have been searching and searching for something important and meaningful to do with my life. And I have done everything I can think of, and I haven't even come close. So I am in utter, abject, complete despair.
And that's it?
Yeah. Yes.
That's it.
Pippin, let me tell you something about despair. I loved my husband very much. The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life. And then, one day, he was struck by fever. And when his hand went cold in mine, I too felt that my life was over. I was overcome by the deepest despair. I took to my bed for 5 days, but on the sixth day, I got up. There were things to be done, the estate to run, boy to raise, and... Pippin, this is such a large estate, and I'm all alone here, and I can't do all this work on my own. Couldn't you help me, please?
Hold it! Hold it! You're supposed to read the line, naggingly. I know, but he put his hand on my face, and they don't usually do that. Listen, I don't care where he puts his hand, read it naggingly! Look, you're almost too old for this role, so you better watch it. Got my eye on you.
Pippin, this is such a large estate. I'm all alone here, and I can't do all this work on my own. Couldn't you help me, please?
All right. Anything to shut you up.
Well, Pippin was finally out of bed and working, and soon he became part of everything, part of our everyday lives.
How often do we do this?
Every day.
Every day?
Uh-huh.
Every day, huh? That sounds like fun.
For a while, Pippin didn't show much enthusiasm for the work, but as time went on, he showed no enthusiasm at all.
Keep up the good work, man. What? What are you looking at?
Nothing. Oh, Pippin, there is something. The roof on the chicken house has sprung a leak, if you can get to that tomorrow. Oh, and the chimney needs bricks, and the field needs plowing, and the pigsty is... It's a sky. Thank you!
I know that look. That's a look of a widow with a son and a large estate and no one to sit at the head of the table. Well, that's not me. You hear me? That's not me! Patching the roof, pitching the hay, it's not my
My idea of a perfect day, when you're extraordinary, you gotta do extraordinary things. I'm not the type to sleep for the size of the compost heap. You're extraordinary, you think about extraordinary things. Oh, I once knew a man, he lived each day the same, same man, the same as well. And when they told me he died, I didn't cry. All I could say was, how could they tell? Oh, looking at life from deep in a rut, when you are viewed with the sunshine, but it's unnecessary for someone who is very extraordinary like me. If the floorboards are squeaking and the doorboards are leaking and the chimneys in the repair, if the garden has brambles and the yard is in shambles, well, I'm terribly sorry, but I don't care. I've got to be someone who lives all the life superlatives. I'm extraordinary, I need to do extraordinary things. That I'm special is easy to see, so why doesn't anybody see it but me? I'm extraordinary, I need to do extraordinary.
Thank you.
day. And then, just after sunset, the duck died.
Wait, no, dear, we can just go to the pond and get a new duck. Why? Why did the damn duck have to die?
And then, an interesting thing happened. Theo plunged himself into monumental despair, while Pippin, that prince of despair, dedicated himself to raising the boy's spirits.
Hey, Theo! We're going out to thresh some grain, and we could really use another good man. Another time, maybe.
But Pippin showed remarkable persistence. When one thing failed, he tried another.
Hey, Theo! Look what I made for you. Yeah, ready, see?
But if it's true,
by themselves, now they don't mean much. Together they send you reeling into a love song. Love, love, la, 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 la. Love song. La, 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 la.
There were other days.
Some men are heroes. Some men outshine the sun. Some men are simple good men. This man wasn't one. And I won't miss his moods, his gloomy solitudes, his blunt, abrasive style. Please don't get me wrong, he was best to come along.
About what life has been. Days are tame and nights the same.
giant bird, it soars to the sea. And if I'm never tied to anything, I'll never be free.
What the hell are you doing here? Pippin, enough with the nonsense and get on with the finale!
Show me crimson gold and lavender, mirages to touch. I wanted such a little thing from life. I wanted so much. I never came close, my love. We nearly came near. Never was there. It always was.
You'll see what it's like without us. Take down the set. Take down the set. Let's go! Everything out! I want the stairs out! Set out! Go! Come on! Let's go! Colored lights? Out. Pinks, reds, I want it all out. Not so flattering, is it now, Pippin? Costumes. Get the costumes. Makeup, wigs, costumes out! Let's go! Look around, Pippin. How do things look to you now?
Showed me crimson gold and lavender, a shining parade.
A mole, Pippin! Look at the mole on her face! You're gonna spend the rest of your life with a woman with a mole?
There's no color I can't have on earth that will finally fade.
And the kid! Do you know how much he's gonna cost
and
you?
I wanted worlds to paint.
This is the way you wanna live? This is
and
what you want?
To wear.
No makeup?
Was here.
No colored lights?
It never was there.
And no magic! Ladies and gentlemen, we apologize for our inability to bring you the finale we promised. It seems our extraordinary young man has elected to compromise his aspirations. But I know there are many of you out there, extraordinary people, exceptional people, who would gladly trade their ordinary lives for a chance to do one perfect act. Our grand finale. And we will always be there for you anytime you want us. Why? We are right inside your heads. And we promise you sets, costumes, lights, magic. Take out the rest of the lights.
your damn hands off the keyboard! You try singing without music, sweetheart.
I wanted magic shows and miracles, mirages to touch. I wanted such a little thing from life. I wanted so much. I never came close, my love. We nearly came near. Never was there. It always was here.
Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find